Today, we are going to be going to Richmond and to MLK Park as I'm going to be there for some NSL Pacific midweek action between San Pablo FC versus Norcal Rush. Now, we are now week 10 into the NSL Pacific season, and both of these teams have actually played 8 games coming into this game. And so far, both of these teams have been kind of had a contrast all the season, with San Pablo FC having an incredible season so far in second place of the NSL Pacific, and are actually the only unbeaten team in the NSL Pacific with a record of 6-2-0, while for Norcal Rush, well, it has been a disastrous season for them in the NSL Pacific. And remember the last time when I went to a Norcal Rush game and they were playing against Dalek FC and they were able to win 3-2 in that game? That turns out to be the only win that they got this season, and they're actually now on a 7-game winless run and have a record of 1-1-6, and I only got 4 points so far this season. So obviously San Pablo SC, the host, is going to be the heavy favorites coming into this game, but you never know, maybe this could be a game where we could be seeing a bit of an upset. I mean, we've seen before in the Sporthop series, when there is a team that is playing a game and they have an unbeaten record, sometimes we do see some shock in that we do see a bit of an upset where the unbeaten team suffered their first loss of the season. But let's see if that is going to be the case tonight. Let's go soccer.
So we've just arrived here in Richmond and here at MLK Field, and as you can see, both team are doing their pre-game warm-up. Still got roughly about 20 minutes before the beginning of this match, and now it looks like both team is on the pitch. And also, I'm not sure why the camera kind of did not focus there, but we are just about to get ready for the start of this match, and I think the referee is also going to have to tell those people over there to get off the pitch. Yeah, we are just about to get ready to start this match between Norcal Rush and San Pablo FC.
All right, so I think we might have a bit of a delay for this game because it seems like part of the crossbar there is actually broken. And I wonder how the referee and that goalkeeper for San Pablo is gonna try to fix it. This, well, they're actually putting it down now. I guess maybe they are now trying to fix it by doing that. And it looks like it is now fixed, which is good to see. And the referee gets this match underway. San Pablo FC will be going all white tonight, going from left to right, while Norcal Rush will be going all red tonight, going from right to left as we are underway. And already Norcal Rush is on the attack, and this one is going to be cut out there as we almost saw probably one of the fastest goal, if not the fastest goal we ever seen in the Sporthop series to start the game. But we're underway here on this beautiful Wednesday night here in MLK Soccer Field here in Richmond. As here comes San Pablo, and they're gonna try to feed this ball here on the right. The goalkeeper missed this one, and it is gonna be clear off the lines there by Norcal Rush as, well, San Pablo FC almost got the opening goal, but that defender comes to the rescue for the visitor to clear that one off the line. San Pablo looking to try to recycle play. That one actually took a deflection as it puts it back into the box here. And there's still scramble in the box, and it is going to be clear the way there from San Pablo FC or Norcal Rush. Oh, and that's actually a giveaway here. And the goalkeeper comes out, and it is going to be a penalty. Well, the referee points to the spot as that goalkeeper was trying to get to that one, but unfortunately brought down that attacker for San Pablo FC, and it is going to be a penalty coming up here. And here comes the penalty, and it is in the back of the net there, and San Pablo FC have taken a 1-0 lead here, and definitely a well-deserved 1-0 lead because they have been by far the better team in this first 10 minutes of this game. Gonna try to send his attacker forward with a direct ball, and that actually does very well as here comes Norcal Rush as they try to feed the ball into the middle. And is that going to be a penalty? Well, the referee says it is going to be a free kick coming up for NorCal Rush. And while the NorCal Rush player feel like that handball was in the box, and, you know, I do get a very good look at it, and tell you what, I think maybe they have a case. This is a big opportunity for NorCal Rush, who just conceded the penalty a minute ago, to level things up. And that is a disappointing free kick and kind of anticlimactic the way that that was going to be taken. Well, looks like we have some fireworks that is shooting off there. Now, obviously, we are still about 2 weeks away from the 4th of July weekend. And I'm guessing Richmond actually does have a rule where they're not allowed to have fireworks shooting that is not on a 4th of July weekend. So I guess these are just illegal fireworks that is shooting off in the background. Tell you what, there's been some inconsistent decision tonight from the referee as the ball drills in here into the box and the goalkeeper spills it here. And that's a swing and a miss by that NorCal Rush player as they are able to clear it away here for San Pablo FC. And now they could go on the break here as he has a lot of green to run here on the right flank. Runners also are arriving here into the box. And now he's gonna slow things down there, or as, well, that was a big opportunity for a counter, but now here's a big opportunity for the second goal, and it's saved by the keeper, and it's gonna put out for a corner here.
So we play almost half hour into this game, and it is a 1-0 lead in favor of San Pablo FC, but in many ways, this has been a very frantic first 30 minutes of this game, and it's also been a very open game where there's been chances on both ends, and somehow, in some way, it is still only at 1-0. But, you know, if this does continue, I have a feeling we are probably going to see the next goal very soon, because again, it's been a very open game. It's also been very end-to-end with both teams having equal amount of chances.
Pablo certainly has the better opportunity, and here they come again as they feed this ball here into the middle, and it is in the back of the net there, and San Pablo FC has got that second goal. Well, you kind of sense that it was coming, because as I said, San Pablo FC definitely had more of the better look than NorCal Rush has, and indeed they finally was able to put one away after they were kind of being very wasteful for most of their chances. But it is now a 2-0 lead in favor of San Pablo FC. And here comes San Pablo FC again as he's going to drive it in, and it's in the back of the net there, and that is an absolute golazo there from that San Pablo FC player, who makes it 3-0 in favor of his team. It is going to be a corner coming up as the ball delivered into the box here, and it is going to be saved by the keeper there. I think he might have even tipped that one onto the poles.
That might be it, or maybe we might have one last chance here, as that is actually given away there, and big opportunity for the fourth goal here, and it is in the back of the net there, as it is now 4-0 in favor of San Pablo FC. And you know, throughout this first half, one of the things that I mentioned that has happened a lot is a lot of sloppy giveaways from both teams, and especially for NorCal Rush, and that time they made a sloppy giveaway, literally gave the ball in the worst possible,
and that San Pablo FC actually went through on goal. And
that is the halftime whistle. Halftime here in Richmond and at MLK Soccer Field. It is the host all over the visitor NorCal Rush, as San Pablo FC is up 4-0 in this game.
So it's halftime here at MLK Soccer Field in Richmond, as I'm now making my traditional walk to the other side of the stadium. And at halftime, it's San Pablo FC all over NorCal Rush, as they're up 4-0 in this game. But in many ways, as I mentioned, this has been a very open game, and it seems like when you have both of these teams kind of like to play on the transition, that is the reason why this game is very open and it very fast pace, and also tons of opportunity that we saw in this game. But overall, San Pablo FC deserved to be up 4-0, and they probably could have maybe made it 5 or 6-0 if it wasn't for that NorCal Rush goalkeeper that had to be very busy in this game, and also made a couple of big saves in this game to try to keep his side in as long as possible, but really his defense have just completely hung him out to dry, because that NorCal Rush defense, yeah, it pretty much was non-existent in this game so far. But let's see how the second half is going to go. Let's see if we're going to continue to see that fast-paced kind of game we saw here in the first half, and if that is going to be the case, I won't be surprised we're going to see more goals in this one.
And now it looks like both team is back on the pitch, and we are just about to get ready for the start of the second half. And the referee gets this second half underway. Well, after a fast-paced first half, and we definitely saw four goals that's been scored in this fast-paced first half. Let's see, potentially we might see more goals here in the second half. NorCal Rush doing a good job cutting those supply line, but that's a missed clearance there, and the ball has popped up into the air. The goalkeeper didn't get it, and the bicycle effort there is gonna go wide, and well, that would have been a great goal if that one went in, but also would have been a bad defensive mistake there for NorCal Rush Pacific, and maybe go to the national championship, as here comes San Pablo FC again, looking to try to beat it into the middle, and it is in the back of the net there, and it is now 5-0 in favor of San Pablo FC, as, well, that's just add insult to injury to NorCal Rush, as it is pretty much the case where they are truly beaten in this game. San Pablo is actually able to win this possession back, and now they feed this ball here onto the left side. He's gonna drive this one in, and it is gonna go wide there, and well, I think he went with the selfish effort there to try to shoot that one and go for goal, but unfortunately just goes way wide there. Although here comes NorCal Rush, and that player goes for on goal. The flag stays down, and that is saved by the keeper there for San Pablo FC, and that is a great save there to preserve his team the clean sheet to San Pablo FC. And again, there's runner making their runs into the box, and that one is gonna be actually cleared away and actually hit the top of that fence. And I'll tell you what, that car right there, that blue car, whoever is the owner, as that ball comes in, and that is gonna be hot there. Speaking of which, here they come on the attack, and that player is trying to go through on goal there, but instead he actually dragged wide, as now the ball puts in into the middle, and it is gonna be cleared away here for NorCal Rush. That was kind of promising again from San Pablo, and now he's gonna try to drive it from long range, and again it goes over the bar. Well, it is now 6-0 in favor of San Pablo FC, and I gotta say, I actually don't know what happened here, because I was actually just looking at footage off the last clip to kind of see that replay of that long range effort, and then when I looked up, the ball was into the back of the net, and I'm assuming there must have been a bad mistake there from that NorCal Rush defense that basically gave the ball away once again in a bad position, and well, the San Pablo player basically just tapped it and into the back of the net. And indeed, it is now 6-0 in favor of San Pablo FC. But that being said, here they come again on the attack, but that player doesn't really have a lot of help in the box. He's gonna still try to cross this one into the box here, and now that is gonna be a foul there. And now, did that actually happen inside the box? Because if it happens inside the box, it is going to be a penalty, and indeed it is. The referee points to the spot, because as I said, I thought that one happened inside the box, and when that is the case, that has to be a penalty. So NorCal Rush indeed is going to have a chance to prevent them to getting themselves shut out tonight, and are going to have a chance to get one back in this game. Oh, here comes a penalty for NorCal Rush. So looking to try to get a consolation going, trying to prevent themselves from getting shut out tonight. And here's the penalty, and it's in the back of the net there, and NorCal Rush has got one back, but obviously this game is pretty much long over, and as I said, this is more of a consolation, a goal to prevent them to getting shut out. I'm assuming he would just blow the whistle right as we hit the 90, because it's a 6-1 scoreline. This game is pretty much out of reach, but now here comes San Pablo FC again, and it is in the back of the net there, or is it? No, it's not, because
the offside flag is up, and well, actually, I think originally when that player basically hits it, that one went off the post and actually did not cross the line, and that San Pablo player did try to tap it in to make sure it would be number 7, but the problem is that player that tapped it in was in an offside position, and well, actually, no, it is going to be in the back of the net because they are putting the ball in the center circle. So indeed, it is going to be 7-1. So if that is the case, I don't know why the linesman raised his flag for. I think maybe he got the confirmation from the center ref that indeed the first shot that, as I mentioned, came off the post and bounced out. It looks like that one did cross the line.
Ball comes in here on the left side, and it's just gonna go straight to the goalkeeper, and that is the full time whistle. Full time here at MLK Soccer Field here in Richmond. It's San Pablo FC with a 7-1 beatdown over the visitor NorCal Rush.
So it's just finished here at MLK Soccer Field in Richmond, and in the end it finished in a Brazil versus Germany-esque kind of scoreline as it finished with San Pablo FC winning 7-1 against NorCal Rush. And you know, in the second half, although it wasn't as fast paced as we saw in the first half, there was still the similar amount of goals that was scored in the second half as we saw in the first half. And you know, overall I've thing when you look at how this game went, this pretty much just explained why in the beginning I said that, you know, I was maybe hoping maybe we're gonna get like an upset in this game, but also don't be surprised if this could be a blowout kind of game because San Pablo FC, who is way up in the standings, and in fact as of now they're actually at the top of the standing in the NSL Pacific, don't be surprised they're gonna absolutely thrash the team that is currently at the bottom of the standings. But either way, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do, make sure you guys leave a like, smash the subscribe button, and yeah, I of course will see you guys next time with another Sports Hop series episode.